So I have mentioned the coreboot stages, but I haven't yet explained what these are and how they are named. So basically, coreboot consists of 5 to 6 main stages, and the names are as follows. The boot block, it is the earliest stage that is executed right after waking up the machine from sleep. Then there is an optional first stage. First stage is responsible for early firmware verification and is tied to the verified boot implementation. Then we have ROM stage, which main task is to prepare the main memory. Then we have a post car, which tears down the temporary memory environment and prepares the next stage to be run from the main RAM memory. And then we have the last coreboot stage, which is called the RAM stage, and it is responsible for overall hardware initialization, writing various tables that are passed to operating system, and handover to the payload. Payload is not really a part of coreboot, but it is the last stage that coreboot hands over the control to. The payload is anything we want it to be. It can be a bootloader on an application, it may load the target operating system, etc. So each of these stages has its own purpose, and one should not perform tasks of one stage in another. It is enforced by coreboot booting model and to keep behavioral consistency across various platforms. I have mentioned that coreboot consists of multiple stages. But how does it really work? Typically, firmware is a single binary, right? So each of the stages are indeed a separate executable file, but they are packed into a CBFS. CBFS is a coreboot file system that allows to pack the firmware components to create a sort of archive. Of course, there is a tool that allows manipulating the CBF contents called CBFS tool. It is a part of the coreboot repository. It is able to put and remove files from CBFS, apply compression to the files, enforce their alignment or base address in the main memory. It is also capable of manipulating the flash map partition contents. What is flash map, I will describe soon. Besides these features, it can also integrate various file types like boot space images, raw files, 64-bit integers, etc.